नमस्कार। इन टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स। फर्स्ट वी विल सी व्हाट आर डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड व्हाई दीज डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स आर सो इम्पोर्टेंट इन अवर प्रोग्रामिंग। सी दिस पिक्चर, एमएस डॉट बुकशेल्फ। इज इट इजी टू फाइंड आउट अ पर्टिकुलर बुक फ्रॉम दिस? नो, यू नीड टू सर्च द एंटायर शेल्फ फॉर गेटिंग वन, इजंट इट? व्हाट अबाउट दिस बुकशेल्फ? It is well arranged, so we could find out one very easily, right? Same case in our programming also. If our data can be arranged in an organized manner, we can access it very quickly and easily. Here is the use of a data structure. It allows us to store data in such a way that it can be retrieved very quickly and effectively. We can say a data structure is a named group of data of different data types. And it is stored in a specific way and can be processed as a single unit. In a shelf, we can arrange our books in different ways. We can arrange it vertically, we can arrange it horizontally, and also we can place it according to the size. Similarly, our data can also be arranged in different ways based on our needs. That means we are having different data structures also. Choosing the data structure is very important in programming. We will see some data structures. List, tuple and dictionary are some built-in data structures that we already covered. Similarly, there are some user-defined data structures also like stack and queue. In today's class, we will learn stack in detail. Stack is an ordered collection of items. These are two real-world examples of stack: a pile of books and a stack of coins. See this stack of books. Bottom of the stack is inaccessible and top of the stack is accessible. That means we can place a book on its top and also we can take away from the top. So a stack is a linear structure in which insertion and deletion can take place only at one end, that is stack's top. Insertion at the top and deletion also from the top of the stack. A stack is called a LIFO list. LIFO means last in, first out. Here you can see in this stack, the element inserted last, that is at the top, would be the first to be deleted. That is last in, first out. And next we will see some operations that we will do in a stack. First one is push. Push means addition of an element at the top. That is an element is added on the top of the stack. One item pushed and the second item pushed on the top of it. Next is pop. Pop means removal of an item from the top. Here you can see an element is removed from the top of the stack. Next we will see implementation of stack using list. In a stack list, push and pop happen on the same end, and that end we will consider as the top. Push operation and pop operation on the same end. The operations that we are going to do on a stack list are creating a stack list, push, that is adding an element, checking for empty stack, pop, that is deleting an element, and at last displaying the stack contents. First step is creating an empty stack list. You can create an empty list either using list function or you can use list bracket. Next is push operation. It means append an item at the end of the list, or we can say insertion at the top of the stack. To push an element, first you have to accept that element from the user. For that I have used input function. The element that is inputted by the user is now in item, and next is stack.appendItem. Append function is used to add an item at the end of the list. I will just revise what we have studied in list. First creating an empty stack list. Then append an item. For that, stack dot append. I used file. See the content of stack. I'm going to append one more item. Content of stack. Next is pop operation. Pop operation means deletion of an item from the end of the list. To pop an element from the list, the function is pop. It will remove an item from the end of the list. Here x equal to stack dot pop. So the popped element will be there in x. And if you want, you can display the deleted item. I will show you pop operation. Stack dot pop. Last item is popped. Then again stack dot pop. Last item is popped. And if again I give pop, it will display error. Pop from empty list. So before starting the pop operation, we have to check whether the stack or our list is empty or not. To check whether the stack is empty or not, we have three methods. First one is, now the stack is empty, so it returns true. Next is not stack. This also returned true. Next one is using len function, len of stack, whether it is equal to 0. I am going to use the first method because it is simple. Next is displaying the stack contents from top to bottom, or we can say in a list last to first. For that, first I used len function to find the size of the stack. Then I used a for loop to display the elements from the last to the first. The index of the last element is size minus 1, because the list index starts from 0 and ends in size minus 1. And the step value here is minus 1, because we have to move from last to the first. And about the n value, that is minus 1, we want to display up to 0th index. So minus 1 minus of minus 1 is equal to 0. Or we can say we want to move up to 0th index, 0 minus 1 is minus 1. Getting confused? Don't worry, I will show you some examples. See, here I have a for loop. I have given the start value as 10 and the step value minus 1. That is, I want to print it backward. Suppose I want to print from 10 to 5. If I want to print up to 5, then I have to give the stop value or the end value as 5 minus 1. That is equal to 4. See here, if I give 4 here, up to 5, it will display. If you want to print up to 1, you have to give 1 minus 1, that is equal to 0. That is, here the end value you have to give 0. Up to 1 is displayed, 10 to 1. Similarly, if you want to print up to 0, up to the 0th index, you have to give here 0 minus 1, that is minus 1. If I give minus 1, if I give the n value as minus 1, the loop will iterate until it reaches 0. See the result. Up to 0 is displayed. Okay, now you know how to push an element in a stack, how to pop, and how to display the elements of a stack. So next we are going to combine all these together to form a menu-driven program. Implementation of a stack using list. First you have to create an empty list. For that, stack equal to. Next, I am going to give all these operations in a loop. For that, I choose the loop variable as ch, initialized as y, then loop while ch equal to capital Y or ch equal to small y. Inside the loop, I am going to give my menu, that is print, first operation push, slash n, second operation pop, slash n, third operation display. Next, we are going to ask the user to input the choice. Choice equal to input, enter your choice. If choice equal to 1, that is, if the choice is to push an element, first user has to input a value. For that, item equal to input enter the item to be pushed, then stack dot append item. Append function will add an item at the end of the list or at the top of the stack. Next is elif choice equal to 2, that is, if the operation is pop operation, before the pop operation you have to check whether the stack is empty or not. For that, if stack equal to square bracket, if stack is empty, display stack is empty, else x equal to stack dot pop. The pop function will remove an item from the end of the list, or we can say which is at the top of the stack. Now the removed item is there in x, then print the deleted item. Print pop operation is over. Next is display elif choice equal to 3, that is, display operation. First you have to find the size equal to alien of stack. Alien function will return the length of a list, that is, the size of a stack here. Then give a for loop to display the content. For I in range, stack value is size minus 1. Next, minus 1, that is, we want to print up to 0th index, then the step value minus, because we want to print it backward, that is, from the top of the stack to the bottom, or we can say from the end of the list to the first element. Print stack of I, else, that is, if the choice is not 1, 2 or 3, you have to print invalid choice. At last, ch equal to input, do you want to continue? Yes or no? If the user inputs y, the loop will continue its iteration, otherwise it will stop. My program is over. See, in push I have given only input function, that means I can input only string values. If I want to input any type of value, I have to use eval function here. Eval function will evaluate the inputted string and will convert into corresponding data type. So now I can input any type of value. I am going to execute it. F5. Enter your choice 1, enter the item to be pushed. I'm going to push a string A. Do you want to continue? Yes. Enter your choice. One again. Enter the item to be pushed. B. Do you want to continue? Yes. Enter your choice. 3. I'm going to display it. I have two values in my stack. A. Then on the top of A, B. Do you want to continue? Yes. Enter your choice. 2. Deleted item B. The item B, which is at the top of the stack, is removed or poked. Do you want to continue? No. Okay, our data structure stack is over here. Try to practice it today itself. Okay. Thank you. Thank you all.